So welcome back to Toy Box. In this episode, I'm going to be highlighting my top 10 Rummage box finds from last year, 2022. So all the things that I found have come from Rummage boxes, either charity shops, thrift shops, carboot sales, and flea markets here in the United Kingdom. So they're in boxes, you have to look for them, and they normally don't cost very much. And all these items here, and the ones I've highlighted, have cost me less than a pound. So let's crack on straight into the top 10. Okay, so in at 10 we have Starsky's Ford Gran Torino from the 1970s Tactics Show, Starsky and Hutch. And this is a 1977 Corgi Jr.'s die-cast car in a fairly reasonable condition. Still got its decal of sorts and siren. Future restoration project for sure. But I found this in a charity shop in a rummage box and it was 20p. That's in number 10. Okay, so in number 9 we have three G1 Transformers. I found these at the car boot sale in a rummage box of die-cast cars, and everything in the box was 50p each. So here we have three G1 Formers. So we've got two Autobot Construction Patrol figures from the MicroMasters line in the 1990s. We've got this little guy who's called Neutro, and this one who's called Ground Pounder, both in really good condition. And on the far right here we have Sizzle, and he is from 1986. Yes, in number 9, three G1 Transformers. Okay, so at number 8 we have this Kenner Mask figure, and he is called T-Bob from the Mask cartoon from 1985, and that cost me 50p from the car boot sale. So he's at number 8. Okay, so in number 7 we have this vintage Star Wars figure. It's a re-use from the Return of the Jedi line, made by Kenner in 1983. I found this in a curious place. I went to my local model paint shop in one of the back rooms. They had some cardboard boxes with some model kits and some die-cast cars, and I saw this one lone Star Wars figure lying on top. I did have a look through the rest of the box, and there was no other action figures, just this one. And asked the lady how much it was, and she said it was 50 pence. Can never leave a Star Wars beta figure behind, in my opinion. Yeah, so yeah, 50p from the model shop, and he's in number 7. Okay, so in number 6 we have these charming, naive little Zybots made by Remco in 1985. So you had, obviously in the 80s you had Transformers and GoBots, then you had all the other random lines of transforming robots, and this is one of them. So we've got Snowcat here, yeah, check out the stickers on them, well cool, nice and shiny. And here we have Sandmaster. Yeah, these cost me 50p each, and I found them in a box of die-cast cars. Always check the die-cast cars boxes, you never know what you might find. Yeah, so these are in at number 6. There is a cool little clip of Zybots on a robot chicken sketch. I may insert this into the video.
Autobots, we must defeat Megatron!
We are the Zybots! We can also transform. Let us help you fight!
Brave Zybots, I am 100% sure you would die.
Okay, well, thanks for your time.
That was just sad.
Woo! Sorry I'm late.
Who are you?
I'm an Autobot like you. My name is Autobot Johnson.
You look exactly like the Zybots we just spoke to, hastily cobbled together to form a bigger, weirder Zybot.
Okay.
Who hired this guy?
Oh, shit! Give me a second here. Just one second. There.
If you're an Autobot, then transform with loud, showy noises.
You bet! True talk, we lied. But we don't need your permission. We'll fight Megatron all by ourselves. Megatron, meet the Cybot!
Not the Cybots!
We did it!
We did it! We did it!
Megatron?
What the fuck, bro?
Oh, those guys were cute. They really looked like they needed a W.
Okay, so at number 5 we have this 1986 GoBot Rock Lord, and he is called Boulder. I got this from the carboot sale, and it was in a box of McDonald's toys, and it only cost me £10, so that was one of the bargains of last year. So yeah, GoBot Rock Lord, he's at number 5. Okay, so in at number 4 we have the Snap Together Astro Space ship toys, cool little things. They're made in the mid to late 1980s, quite similar to Kinder Egg toys. Yeah, and these were made by a company called Brooder. They're quite sought out after, and they go for quite a bit on eBay. But I got these for less than £1 from a house clearance centre. So I love these, one of my favourite finds from last year. So they're at number 4. Okay, number 3 we have a soft toy, and I'm going to let the soft toy introduce himself to you. Here he is. Yep, that's it. His name is Ed the Duck, and he was a presenter on a show called The Broom Cupboard, which was a show that was for CBBC, which is made for the BBC here in the United Kingdom, and basically it was like a kids' afternoon show of cartoons and whatnot, and it ran from about 3:30 up until about 5:30 in the afternoons when kids got home from schools, and it was broadcast from the mid-80s up until the mid-90s. And Ed the Duck here, you on the sidekicks, sorry, presenters, during that time, what year were you presenter? Oh, 1990-ish, fair enough. Yep, so Ed Duck, hand puppet, and this guy cost me £1 from the carboot sale, and it's a worthy addition to the collection of my 1980s curios and toys and whatnot. Yep, so he's number 3, he's cool. Okay, so in number 2 we have an action figure, one of the iconic wrestlers of the 1980s, and this guy is Andre the Giant, and it is a Hasbro WWF 1990 figure of him, and I got this from a charity shop amongst some other wrestlers from that time period, and they all cost me a 50p each. This good bargain and a worthy addition to the collection. Okay, so in number 1 we have some Takara Penny Racers from the early 80s. Originally known as Crow Q in Japan in the late 70s, Takara then got the license and made them in America and Europe. So these two are from 1981 and 1982 respectively. I got them from the carboot and I spent 40p on one and 20p on the other, and the reason why they're called penny racers is because you put a penny in the back of here and you race them. I got these on the same day at the car boot, and this one is particularly special. This is my favourite find of the year.
Yeah, it's a bit
and
broken
my son
too.
Is gonna tell you why is this one the best find of the year. It's because you found it, wasn't it?
Yeah, so I saw my dad buying lots of wine, because they thought stored that the wine called this wheel, and then I just picked it up, and then he just said yes, he wants to keep it, and then he bought it.
Yeah, so my son is aware that I like little wind up cars, and I always keep my eye out of penny races, and he saw this one in a die cast Rummage car box, and he was like, oh daddy, I think you might like this, and I did. And I saw his car, a penny racer, and I thought, wow, amazing, Great find. Thank you, son. And, yeah, what makes it even a bit more unique, that is a glow-in-the-dark one.
By the way, it's a bit broken on that top bit there.
A little bit broken. Doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. They're meant to be, toys meant to be played with. Doesn't matter if it's a bit broken.
Okay.
I can always fix that if I wanted to. But I'm going to display it. It's displayed as is here at Poncho's Toy Box. So there you go, my top 10 Rummage Box finds from last year, 2022. If you're a fan of 1980s and 70s toys and nostalgia from that era, yeah, give us a subscribe. And if you see Rummage Boxes at car boot sales and charity shops, you know, have a rummage through. You never know what toy nostalgia and gold you will find. Yeah, so thanks for watching, and I'll see you in another video. I think Ed Duck wants to quickly say something. Yeah, if you like the video, click the like button and subscribe to the channel. Bye-bye.